Actually, ATOM report, annual report, is a recognition of the power of the people. It is a clear admission na kamo katawhan ang akong agalon. Kamo katawhan sa dakbayan ang mao ang gamhanan. And so since I assumed office July of 2013, I would regularly deliver my annual report to the people of Cagayan de Oro. And we decided na atong annual report would be done in time during the Charter Day celebrations. Again, akong usbon pagrekognisar of the sovereign power of the people. Of course, all of us, tanang officials, gikan sa presidente, paingon sa barangay kagawad, we are subject to the Constitution. O diha sa atong batakang balaod, nag-ingon, that public office is a public trust and all government authorities emanate from the people. No, all government authorities emanate from the people. And in fact, it has been said time and again, kay tungod lagi nga gamhanon ang katawhan, na the voice of the people is the voice of God. And precisely, mao kana usad ang tuyo sa piliay. Ang tuyo sa piliay is to make our democracy stronger. Every year that passes, our democracy must be stronger. It cannot, and we should not allow it in any way na magluya, mag-weaken ang democracy. Because as that democracy weakens, the people get confused. And as the people get confused, chaos and confusion will prevail. Disorder, lawlessness will govern. Mao nga ang eleksyon, ang tuyo niya na isa katawhan are given their right, their power. It is both a right and a power to choose their officials. Along the way in the election, dili malikayan because that is given. There will be contending parties. There will be issues of clear disagreement. Along the way, ang katawhan sa mabahin. But it is not as if that the election is meant to divide the people. At the end of the day, after the election is done, the objective is that that election should unify the people. Unify us under one flag. Unify us under one government. And there is only one government in the entire country, and that is the government of the Republic of the Philippines. O kita sa local level, whether provincia, ciudad, municipio or barangay, we are not a separate government. We are part and parcel of that national government. It's just that the national government has delegated to us, gisangunan kita, to do certain functions, to do certain responsibilities on behalf and in representation of the national government. Mao ka na nga we would always and we should always be guided by one flag, one government, one regime. at the end of the day, still public service is what many of the top-notch public servants have defined it to be. And dinis ato sa sila ni Pilae, sila ni Borra, sila ni Nene Pimentel, they have always, no, grabe ang ilang definition sa public service. Pilae defined public service as an apostleship. Muna ang iyang, dito sa iyang opisina, all his, sa iyang opisina, behind him, sa iyang lamisa, naa ang imahe sa washing of the feet. To remind him of the humility that even Jesus Christ has submitted himself to. Na mismo siya iyang ihugasan ang mga tiil sa iyang mga apostoles. In total submission. Of course, si Tining Borra, naaliya sa iyang istatua, inon siya nga, life is a gift. And what a wonderful gift it is. The more you give of yourself, the more rewarding life can be. Not in terms of material reward, but in terms of happiness and fulfillment. Dapat siya isulting, in this transient world, what is enduring are truth, honor, respect, and pride. Although words to that effect. Very inspiring words. During the crisis that I went through, kami ni former Senate President Nene Pimentel would exchange messages. And I shared with him the learnings that I have gathered. Sabi ninyo, in the most difficult times, daghan po gihapon mga learnings that you gather. Daghan mga learnings. To me, the most important learning was ang pagrekognisar again of how powerful people can be. Even kanang mga tao sa kadaplinan, how powerful they can be. Our city, our province, our region have always been a rich source of public servants who made our city, our province, our region, our island proud and stand tall. So mao ka na ang atong gusto nga mapasa sa atong mga anak. Ang akong hangyo karon, we owe the people of Cagayan de Oro nothing less than the best of us. Ang akong hangyo is, let us move together, let us move forward together as one team, as one group, regardless of our political colors. Regardless of our political persuasions, the people deserve nothing but the best service possible. Looking ahead, we can work together na dili kinahanglan nga i-download. Na ay kinahanglan i-download, we will download. Regardless of political colors. The strategy is to maximize the resources that are available. Katili nga ang aturang kaugalingong pundo ang atong tanahon. Asa ang 20%, asa ang general fund, asa ang SEF. If we want to be successful, our strategy should be to look at the other sources without necessarily confining ourselves with local revenues, without necessarily confining ourselves with Iran. Kay mo magkana ang atong main sources, the central government support, which is called the IRA, and ang atong local revenues. Yes, dako na nga pundo, pero mas dako nga pundo ang atong ma-raise if we leverage on those funds. We leverage on those funds. Atong imoon, magkurambos kita with the national government and with other agencies. Kay pagkurambos na to, ang atong piso, 100 na ang atong. Nakaroon ang complete aid or financial assistance. That's a thing of the past already. That even the multilateral agencies, the donor agencies like USAID, JICA, and everyone, wala na'y total aid. What they want is, if you want to be helped, you must also put your equity into the project. You have to put your money where your mouth is. Moingon ka nga priority ka na nimo, then you have to invest in that. Term karon, kung ato lang ka nang na-maximize na siminto na unta tanan, ang dalan pa ingos bisigan, tumpagon, tanan kabukiran, burot na unta ang siminto. Tuwa na unta kita karon sa connecting barangays. Dan sulihon to tagpangi, paingon sa taglibaw, and so on and so forth. Dalanan na unta ato karon ang kamansi sa Epes Katanik. Ang migtuksok sa kugman, nadalanan na unta na. Pero na-stall kita. Kay daghan ka itong mga projects sa Department of Agriculture. Ang atong puhunan was only 10%. In other words, mugasto kita o piso, ang project that we would get is worth 10 pesos. Mugasto kita o 1 million, ang project that will be implemented will be worth 10 million. 10% ra ang puhunan nato. Ang barangay need not even have to contribute to put in the equity because the city is prepared to do that. Unay gitawag nga leveraging. Leveraging on our resources. Binugoy nga istorya, kurambos. Naanad kita niya na, gusto nato mong palit o pan, pero kulang ang kwarta sa atong bulsa. What do we do? Atong ulan, atong mga barkada, uy, magkurambos ta, para palit na itong pan. American bread, kay dako. Bain-bainon na yun. The little money that we have can buy one loaf of American bread. Naapay soft drinks tayo, kinapay sobra. Ang pagkurambos can produce results that are far beyond that what we can afford. So daghan kaya na. Daghan ang atong nahimo sa atong mga tinguha, pagservisyo, apan mas daghan paunta ang atong nahimo kung doon ay Timor. Pero naay mga funds that are considered as special funds. Na kaluis sa Diyos, dili na kinalan iagi sa City Council. Like the Special Education Fund. Mao ka na nga, kaluis sa Diyos, kanang Special Education Fund has served the city and our people well. We are now very much ready for the K-12 that will start this year. Kagahapon, we had our local school board meeting. And ilang ipakita ang pictures ng mga of the buildings that we have constructed. The high-rise buildings. Abi ninyo, we had all believed that Cagayan de Oro is an education center. And yes, Cagayan de Oro is an education center. Gisugdan ka na in 1909. When the Misamis High School was established by the Americans here because of the accessibility of Cagayan de Oro from all sources, from all directions. Misamis was the headquarters before of the Spaniards. That Misamis became later Osami City when it was converted to a city. Incidentally, ang Osami City as a city is older than Cagayan de Oro. What does it show? Of course, it shows that Osamis was way ahead of Cagayan de Oro, especially during the Spanish era. Ngano? Because Panguil Bay provided a natural protection militarily for Osamis and the adjoining areas. But when the Americans wanted to introduce education, they had to choose a place that would be accessible from everywhere. And they chose Cagayan de Oro. Pero karon, there is another milestone that we are witnessing. Kining K-12 has provided a very difficult challenge sa tanan all over the country. Diliti ang hagit kay lagi wala na first year this year and next year. Wala na first year college. Kaya nga no, they will stay in the high schools. So di modo, the sizes of our high schools will increase by the number of what of the would have been graduating class. Because they cannot graduate towards a junior high school or senior high school, they will stay. Resulta, shortage of classrooms. Mao ka na ang resulta. Maayo na lang, kalis sa Diyos, that we have embarked on the classroom project as early as 2013. Now, Cagayan de Oro is ready. Pero dagan pa kulang. But what is now developing, and I learned this yesterday in our meeting sa local school board, what is now developing is Cagayan de Oro is being reinforced as the education center of the region. Kaya nga no, ang mga eskwelahan around Cagayan de Oro, maglisod naman na makakope up sa K-12. So those students come to Cagayan de Oro. Dili lang katong regular migrants that have been coming here or regular student migrants that have been coming here over the years na dugangan tungod sa K-12. So, unsay resulta niya na? There will be more people in Cagayan de Oro. More demand for boarding houses. More demand for restaurants and all that. Of course, more traffic also. Pero mao kana ang ako mensahe. That can also present an opportunity, but that opportunity we can maximize for our people and for our city if we address that properly. It can also be a liability if not properly addressed. Even ako, mga private schools and colleges were a bit worried what will happen because of the 8-12. Even ako, hey, usaw nila pag maintain and upgrade sa ilang mga eskwelahan. Wala may bagong first year, this year and next year. Even ako niya na, and we will address that. We will address that. Because ang ako saan is Cagayan de Oro must, ang position of Cagayan de Oro as the education center must never be undermined. Kinahanglan atong protektahan ang atong advantage. Our educational system in Cagayan de Oro is our crown jewel. Niya din ni ang edukasyon, and this is where future leaders of our country are molded. This is where formation is being done sa atong mga kabataonan, not only from Cagayan de Oro, but also from the region and elsewhere. So we have to protect our educational status. sa health services, kaloy sa Diyos. May nakayong lakaw sa Gerald Borra. Ang atong city health, okay na po sa atong mga health centers. But then again, tungod lagi sa mga budgetary issues, lisod yun. May na lang na ay subsidy. Mayo na lang that the law on PhilHealth says that all PhilHealth payments arising from claims must be flowed back sa health services. And these are considered as special funds. So di na kinalan mo agi sa city council. Pero maling Diyos, and my commitment is, we will disclose and in fact seek the city council's collaboration in everything that we do, including special funds. Tagaila ko sa kooperasyon. I will be accountable for everything that I do or that I do not do. Mawa ng itat pamagi so that we can still serve the people the best way possible. Salamat sa ato mga health providers. Ang JR Borra is positioned to be further upgraded, giving justice to the name, justice to the person who founded it 64 years ago, mga Ikson. The name Siniano Arbora will be carried by that hospital with pride and dignity because that was precisely the person who thought of the city being able to serve its people in health services without relying on any other branch of government. Let the dream of Justiniano Borra be achieved to its total and optimal level. Let the dream of Justiniano Borra serve as a reminder not only to everyone today, but to all generations of the future, including those who are still unborn. Let that dream remind them that hospital care is Cagayan de Oro's dream. Kaloy sa Diyos, sa infrastructure na ay agi, although, and yet in spite of that, ang atong nasimento close to 50 kilometers, in spite of the limiting conditions, taliwala sa paglisod-lisod, nahimog yapon. Ang importante sa I really want to share kay amin ninyo ang disaster, ang calamity can be painful, ang problema can be frustrating, but there are lessons that these bring. Behind those problems, behind those disasters, behind those calamities is a white cloud, a clear sky that will guide you for a better tomorrow. Ano ito po? Tungod lagi sa pag-lisod-lisod. So, nakatuon kita. And the bureaucracy has learned na mangitan pa agi. So professionalism has been improved. Professionalism has been made the norm. We have to be better. We have to give the best so that the best can be delivered. Gone are the days na ang atong mga department heads, ang atong mga departments, would just second-guess the chief executive. Gone are the days when atong mga department heads, atong mga department officials will just wait for the local executive to say what he wants to do. This is the day where mauna, ang atong mga department heads are empowered to think for themselves. And not only empowered, are mandated to think of ways that they can serve better. mao kanang akong nakita sa God blessing taliwala niining paglisod-lisod. So karon pangayo ka sa atong engineering, sa mga plano, sayo na kayo. Because they know. Di man mahimo, di man pareha niya ito nga ingon nga, oh, buhata ka na. Ang tubag lang rin, kanusa, buhaton. Yan, lukso. Asa na floor, lukso. Pero karon ba na? Professionally done. Professionally done. And the program of works are made professionally. Aware nga naindagan ng mga mata ang mutanaw niya. So the sense of accountability has improved. The sense of responsibility has likewise been enhanced. And with that high sense of accountability, with that high sense of responsibility, comes also the high sense of fulfillment sa atong mga kauban. Taliwala sa mga paglisod-lisod, nahimo nila. Nahimo nila. Tungod sa ilang kakugi, tungod sa ilang professionalism. Looking ahead, daghan pa kayong ikinangan. Sa atong mga eskwelahan, we need to build, akong estimate, 800 classrooms, including our oral central, and gani i-appeal na nato ang MOGS, kay lagi bisan tuod, dili siya sakop sa division of Cagayan de Oro, pero ang mga estudyante are all from Cagayan de Oro. And also, because we realize why MOGS has remained to be and will remain to be under the division of Ms. Amis Orinta. Salamat kang Director Fernando for being with us today. Abi ninyo, the moment we remove MOGS from Ms. Amis Orinta, then MOGS has to be prepared to move out of their campus. Kaya ng yuta na gi-occupy sa MOGS is owned by the province of Ms. Amis Orinta and not by Cagayan de Oro City. Mao kana ang lesson of the past that we should remember. And so we should not consider MOGS as different from Cagayan de Oro. MOGS remains with Ms. Amis Oriental because of that historical significance. And because if we remove MOGS from Ms. Amis Oriental, the problem will be far greater than what we face now. But sa ako, the more important, and in fact, the most important reason why we should help MOGS is we owe ourselves to MOGS. If the Americans had decided to build Misamis High School in the town of Misamis in 1909, Cagayan de Oro would not be where we are now. Misamis Oriental would not be what we are today. That move of the Americas was the single most important defining moment for both Cagayan de Oro and Misamis Oriental. And even for the region. Even for the region. Imagine transferring the convergence area from Osami City to Cagayan de Oro. That must have been met with many raised eyebrows at the time. Because at that time, the capital of Misamis was the town of Misamis. Mao kana ang lesson of history. So, daghan pa ato buhaton sa health services. We will upgrade our health centers. And we will build at least two hospitals pa, both districts, the first and the second district, on top of the JR board. We can do it. We can do it. So good siguro ta sa 20-bed hospital. Para at least ma-decongestion ang traffic. And then ang atong health centers, ato pang i-raise ang level of capacity. We will pursue our prime heart agenda. Of course, peace and order, criminality and drugs will be at the centerpiece of this national administration. And tanaw ko kanang blessing that we want to see. Kanang blessing. So, suportahan nato ang incoming administration. Abilin nyo, katong nahitabo sa Orlando yesterday or the other day, where about 50 were killed senselessly and more than 50 were wounded. I was stunned when one analyst said over CNN, nag-ingon ang analyst, that the number one duty of government is to protect its citizens. Wow. Of course, we knew that all along. Pero dito, makapatandog to hear those words that the number one duty of government is to protect its citizens. Nakaibalo na taana, pero to be reminded once again of that. Maong dili sayon. Dili sayon. Because not only because ang size atong police is limited. Sunod, daghan na kayo mga vested interest groups. Daghan na kayo mga vested interest groups. In fact, the most difficult challenge that this incoming administration faces is the challenge that the vested interest groups will bring. Now, appeal na ang criminality, appeal na ang drugs, and so on and so forth. It's a blessing na ang incoming president was once mayor for many terms. And an added blessing na taga Mindanao. Pero he cannot do it alone. Dili makaya. No president can do it alone in this world. No one person can do everything alone. What's important is, kita sa dakbayan, we do our share. And I have to admit na di na po mahimo alone. Kinahanglan magtinabangay kita. Uban ang city council, uban ang atong bureaucracy, uban ang atong mga barangays. Everybody must take, people have already spoken. And no matter how sincere our criticism may be, of course, ipaabot din natin yan, but ang importante is, tumulong na lang tayo. Criminality and drugs are very important. In fact, like I said the other day, if you analyze, why did he get so much overwhelming support? Dili lang from Mindanao, even from Luzon and the Visayas, grabe na suporta. Nagparada siya sa Alabang, grabe na tao dito. Never before has so many people been gathered by a motorcade. As he did it, my daughter texted me, and this was 1 week or 10 days before the election. My daughter texted me and said, "Ingon siya, I have never seen so many crowd before. I have never seen so many people so ecstatic about his coming." Grabe. So, yun lang ko. Criminality and drugs are very close to the hearts of the people. Why? Dahil gobyerno lang ang nakaka-address niya. Ang economy, you have the market forces. In fact, ang market forces will govern the economy. And our market forces, we know, cannot be legislated. You cannot amend the law of supply and demand. Look at market forces are built by society. Community, the community itself already provides that. It's not as if that the market forces are dictated by government. No. In fact, market forces can go against the government. Kung dili maayo ang pagdumala. But criminality and drugs, only the government can do that. Mao nga, you try to analyze, the people have become decency worried. Decency, nanay decency fatigue. Kapoy na ang tao sa pabinutan. Kapoy mo ka na, una nga, garaan na sa po, pumalik ka sa satani. Pero ang ako is, of course, we can do that. Still, we respect the rule of law. We can do that. Still, we respect human rights. We can enforce the law without violating the law. We can enforce the law the way it should be enforced, by upholding the law. Nothing can be worse than the law being enforced by a lawbreaker. Nothing can be worse by a law enforcer being disobedient to the law. So, kinala na tinabangay kita. We need to address ang size sa police cannot be increased that easily. Kaya nga no, ang cost component niya na dako kayo. Because ang retirement sa police o sa military pareho ra. Let's say I retire now, I receive a pay of X amount. And then years after, the pay for my position is increased from X to XX. As a retiree, I will be entitled to XX as my retirement benefit. So, gadako ang cost sa pag-maintain. Na adobe kay ang ilang retirement age kay 56. So, maabot pag si Tinta, so you have 14 years at least to matag. Muna gadako ang ilang cost. Even if the numbers remain constant. So we have to look for solutions that would be within the constitutional and legal bounds. Of course, the constitution mandates that the police is civilian and national in scope. Dili ka na siya pwede localized. But we have to think of ways na ma-reinforce ang atong police without relying on the national government. So, dako kayong tabang ana ang atong mga barangays. Ang akong advice, akong sugyot is, let's do it even before the national government does it. I know nga naanay mga ubang LGUs that had already been thinking of how to address that. Because we cannot expect that the police can do everything and anything with their limited size. Ang ilagani karong na i-hire non-uniform personnel na para ang uniform personnel can do police work to save on the very limited resources. So, limited ang resources sa police because of that circumstance, we have to think of ways to augment the resources, to augment what is available. Of course, at the end of the day, importante kayo ang vigilance. Vigilance. Kung gusto nato maundang ang droga, kaya man nato. Of course, number one, sa ato mga pamilya. Number two, sa ato mga silingan, sa ato mga communities. I know it's not going to be easy. We'll just have to make the proper approaches. The drug problem is a sickness. Those drug addicts are not criminals, they are victims. Maswerte lang kita sa atong panahon nga wala may droga. Maswerte kita. Pero kung dili nato ni-address, unsa ba may atong paaboton, ang atong mga apo, mga drug addict na, ayan na kita masuko, simba ko. Mao nga we have to move now. We have to move without even relying on the national government. We can do it. We can solve it. Cagayan de Oro has always responded to all adversarial situations. Cagayan de Oro had always responded well to all challenges, to all obstacles, and to all difficulties. And yes, we will respond. Ang importante ang pagtinabangay, pagkaiusap. With this, let me close by once again saying salamat sa tanan, salamat kayo sa pagtinabangay, salamat kayo sa panag-iusa. We will bring Cagayan de Oro to greater heights and make Cagayan de Oro a proud city and a more livable city. Happy anniversary! Dagang salamat ug maayong buntag sa tanan.